Hello, thank you for joining the Texas Instruments new product update webinar series. We are thrilled to announce that Texas Instruments will be transitioning the webinar series from WebEx to ON24. This transition will go into effect with our upcoming MPU webinar scheduled for Thursday, May 11th. Be sure to visit ti.com/MPU to register or reach out to your TI salesperson or field application engineer for the registration link. A few quick announcements before we get started. This webinar will be recorded and available online at ti.com/MPU. All phone lines will be muted, so if you have questions, please use the chat box and we will try to answer in real time, or you can contact your TI salesperson or field application engineer. Today's topic is learn about TI's automotive PMIC portfolio and TPS65219-Q1 for powering Sitara AM62x-Q1. I will now pass it over to Lakshmi Sriraman for introductions.
Thank you, Kelly. Welcome everyone. Today, we are gonna learn about the TI's PMIC automotive portfolio and our new product TPS65219-Q1 that powers up the Sitara MPU, AM62X-Q1, and AM62A-Q1 processors. My name is Lakshmi Sriraman. I am in the product marketing supporting the PMIC portfolio for non-functional safety applications. Along with me, I have Brenda Diaz. She's the product applications engineer who will be taking any questions you guys have throughout this presentation. So if anything comes up, please feel free to send a chat message to her to help answer any questions you guys have. Without any further ado, let's get started. Here's what we have on the agenda today. I will walk through a quick overview on the TI PMIX. A quick summary on the automotive PMICs that we have in our portfolio. I also have a slide on the PMIC recommendations and the power solutions for the Sitara Auto MPU for powering up the AM62X and AM62AQ1 processors. I also have an overview of our new product, TPS65219, a quick overview and a quick one-pager, a high-level summary on this device. I also have a slide on the value proposition, on the schedule and the release to market for this device. I have a few slides also on the power trees to help power up the AM62X1 processors that helps show the power solutions as well as the interface that happens between the PMIC and the processor. Again, if there are any questions, feel free to chat, send a chat message to Brenda Reyes. She's our product applications engineer who's available to answer any questions you have throughout this presentation. A quick overview on the PMIC portfolio about why our TI PMICs are preferred worldwide. Our TI PMICs are scalable as well as differentiated PMIC solutions for powering both TI attached as well as non-TI attached processors and in both automotive as well as industrial to grow faster than the market. These PMICs actually harness our latest power technology to help reduce system complexity because they have built-in LDO regulators, DC-DC regulators, sequences, load switches, et cetera, which helps to simplify our design compared to a fully discrete solutions. This PMIC actually helps to reduce not only the component cost, but overall system cost and is optimized for overall cost-effective solution. The problems we are solving with our PMICs are these PMICs are scalable and optimized power solutions that are across high and low power variants. These help reduce the BOM through integration of monitoring and the sequencing features. And there are no hidden costs. And these PMICs not only support functional safety, but they also support non-functional safety applications. These PMICs actually help in reducing the board space through integration. And these are also plug and play solutions with validated reference designs for our SoCs. To jump to the overall automotive PMIC solution and a summary, our PMICs are actually scalable because they have effective programmable output solutions and they are automotive qualified for both functional and non-functional safety applications. Our PMICs also support various sectors that are listed here, for example, ADAS, info cluster, hybrid electric and powertrains, and body electronics and lighting applications. I have a few automotive solutions listed here that power up and support these various sectors and end equipments that we have. And I'm going to run through a slide on the power solutions that we have to support the automotive MPU power solution here. Our PMIC recommendations are actually split into functional safety and non-functional safety devices. For AM62x-Q1 PMIC, on the left, you see the non-functional safety power solution, which is the Fraser device, TPS65219-Q1, and we'll talk about this more in the upcoming slides as well. This is a 3-buck 4LDO device, which comes in a 5x5 package, 32-pin wettable flank device, and QFN package. We have the samples available right now, and the planned release to market for this device is planned for June 23. The functional safety part is powering up the AM62X processors, the solution that we have available right now. Supporting samples is the LIA device TPS65993-Q1, which has 5 bucks and 4 LDOs. It's an 8x8 device, 56-pin package, wettable flank QFN with a planned RTM in 2Q23. The next gen solution for this for this processor is the Burton TPS65223Q1 device, which has 4 bucks, 3 LDOs, and it has a solution with and without the ADC. Comes in a 5x6 package, 36-pin non-wettable flank and wettable flank QFN. Planned RTM March 24 and September 24 for the wettable flank. Samples available sometime in 2Q of 24 for the wettable flank. So jumping on to the Fraser, or the new product that we have for today, is the TPS65219 device. This is a 3-buck 4LDO configurable PMIC that supports various target end equipments like listed here, cockpit domain controllers, TCUs, e-mirror, rear seat entertainment, display modules, driver monitoring systems, etc. This PMIC not only powers up the TI SoCs like the AM62X and AM62A, this also helps in powering up non-TI SoCs like the Xilinx, Spartan X, Artix processors as well. In addition to that, it also helps in power up of general purpose loads like the Ethernet switches, FPD link SerDes, Ethernet 5s, and PCIe switches. I'll jump to the quick overview or the high-level summary of the TPS65219-Q1. This is a 3LDO, 3-buck 4LDO configurable PMIC. The main features include an integrated step-down converter and a 2.3 MHz switching frequency, which reduces the overall component and the total solution size. This is fully programmable sequencing and output voltages. It's flexible to power up many subsystems and processors. As you can see, it has dynamic voltage scaling capabilities on buck 1 and buck 2. It has programmable power sequencing and default voltages, which with I2C interface. It's optimized for systems requiring about 7 to 14 rails. Its configurable GPIOs and multifunctional pins make it extremely compatible to be able to support spectrum as well. This again comes in a 5x5 package, 0.5 mm pitch. This is an AEC-Q100 automotive qualified functional safety capable PMIC. The main applications include powering up AM62X and AM62A processors supports various end equipments like telematic control units, LiDAR, digital cluster, etc. Jumping to the next slide. The TPS65219 value proposition. The three key features or the value propositions for this device are the smaller solution size and the cost. As I mentioned earlier, this has 3 bucks and 4 LDOs, which has optimized rail count, and it is featured set to power up the automotive MPUs for non-functional safety applications. It is a functional safety capable PMIC with fully programmable sequencing. It comes in 5x5 package, 0.5 mm pitch, wettable flank. It's an automotive grade Q1 qualified device with an operating temperature of negative 40 to 125 C, ambient with a junction temperature of 150 C. It also has a wettable flank to help with the automotive optical inspection, which helps during the automotive assembly. Again, this is the recommended PMIC to supply for non-functional safety applications. We have the power trees, which shows the power up of the processors and the power interfacing available right now. We also have the software PMIC drivers available to work with certain MPUs that we can help provide if needed. This is a TI functional safety capable device, and the fit rate, FMD, PIN-FMEA documentation can be provided if needed. Jumping to the scheduled release of this device, we are supporting the samples right now for Fraser. The preliminary data sheet is already available online, and I have a link posted in the slides later for the preliminary data sheet as well as the product folder. This device was APL'd on April 23rd. The planned release to market date is June, and the PPAP for this device will be available in July 23. The sample generation for any of these OPNs that are listed on here takes at least 6 weeks, just an FYI. Any new OTPs can be supported with a cycle time of about 10 to 12 weeks, just to include the additional time that is needed to help define as well as validate the NVM configuration. Jumping to the TPS65219 multifunctions pins capability that we have, this slide actually shows the multifunction pins capability. For example, the enable pin can be used or configured as a push button, monitor input, as well as a vSense comparative input that is fully configurable to be able to monitor a pre-regulator. In addition, we have multi-functional capabilities on the mode pin, the standby pin as well, where we have the low power mode command that disables selected rails, and both these functions, the mode and the standby capability, can be combined as well. So overall, these digital pins are fully configurable to be able to set and define and configure in multiple functions that are listed here. Here's a slide on the pinout for this device. This is a 5x5 wettable flank 0.5 mm pitch with 32 pins. People online can review this once the slides are available. All right, in the next slides that I have ongoing here are some of the power trees to help power up the AM62A Q1 as well as the AM62X Q1 processors with our PMIC TPS65219-Q1. This is an optimized solution for this processors for non-functional safety applications, and this is the most cost-optimized design we have with fully programmable sequencing and the output voltages, output voltage monitoring capability on all the rails. We have GPOs for external rails as well with highly efficient DC-DCs in a smaller size 5x5 QFN. And this picture here actually shows a PDN with a 5-volt input on the LPDDR4 memory. I have another slide showing the PDN for 3.3 volt input, powering up the LPDDR4 capability. The OPN for this is actually listed here. The TRM link is already available online. I have the link posted here as well. I have some more slides which powers the DDR4 memory with a 3.3 volt input as well as the 5 volt inputs. Feel free to reach out if there are any questions on this. And I also have a slide on the power solution size estimation powering up the AM62X Q1 processor. This solution size actually includes the PMIC as well as the main passive components. It does not include any external ICs and the passives here. The overall solution size for the AM62X comes down to about 148 mm as you see here in this table. Moving to the next slide, these slides actually show the power solutions for the AM62A Q1 devices with different PDNs with a 5-volt input as well as 3.3-volt input powering up the LPDDR4 memory as well as DDR4 capability here as well. These voltage monitoring, this device has voltage monitoring on all the rails and the GPOs for external rails as well. It has a minimum output voltage support of about 0.75 volts for VDD core. Here's a quick slide on the VN 5-volt powering up the DDR4 memory for AM62A-Q1. A quick slide on the power solution estimation with the AM62A1 power solution. All right. Last slide here, I have the links posted for this device for TPS 65219. We have the product folder that's already available on ti.com. If anyone wants to review the PMIC portfolio, we have different devices powering up both the automotive as well as the industrial sectors here. The link is posted and can review all the PMIC selection guides that we have. The link to the EVM was also listed here, and if anyone has any technical questions on this TPS 65219-Q1, feel free to click on this link and post it on e2e.com. That's all I have. Kelly, can take it over.
Yes, thank you. And thank you everyone for attending today's MPU webinar. Just a reminder to please visit ti.com/MPU to register for the upcoming MPU webinars beginning May 11th on ON24. See you next week for our next topic, Next Generation Low Voltage Dual Bridge Motor Driver with Current Regulation. Thank you everyone and have a great day.
Thank you.